When you're in the middle of an outbreak, wearing a mask might make people feel a little bit better, and it might even block a droplet, but it's not providing the perfect protection that people think that it is. And often, there are unintended consequences. People keep fiddling with the mask and they keep touching their face.
And a surgical mask, let's start with that one, does not protect you from the from a respiratory virus. It's got leaks all around it, and it's really designed as a barrier protection for people in the operating room. That's why they call it a surgical mask. The average person out there, the average citizen, that mask is not going to protect them, and as a matter of fact, in most cases, they're actually going to increase their risk of being contaminated with a virus when they're wearing that mask improperly, because they tend to touch their face, they tend to move it around. It's very uncomfortable, it's hard to breathe in. Not only are you not preventing yourself from getting a disease, you may be increasing your chance of getting a disease by wearing that mask.
So we aren't touching our mask and moving it around, and that is not a problem, and the gaps in air and unfitted masks really were not a problem. That we were just making that up. We were
yesterday, as with Kamala Harris in Arizona after her outstanding debate performance. Remember Cindy McCain, John McCain's wife, a widow, and my good friend of this great school, Ryan. He got to swear at his dad as a United States citizen. You're just trying to do right by your family this challenging time. You just want a fair shot. Up in Scranton when I was in grade school, he worked hard to build a decent middle class life. He's over 60 years of age. I'm not making this up.
So when I was, and I wanted to, because when I read that this is his debut album, so I went back. And I'm like, I guess these are projects. He has released under Griselda. He's released under his own imprint. He's released under Big Ghost. So not only is he making a lot of money for himself, he's making a lot of money for other people. You know what I'm saying? But the amount of projects that he's releasing, man, it's ridiculous.
What did he say? I made 100 mil or something like that.
Y'all know mine.
Yeah, y'all know mine. That's how you know you're getting old. You're like, y'all know what I'm talking about.
Interpret that shit yourself.
You know, Buddha always, I met him through.
Buddha!
I met him through you too. Yeah, man, you know.
I met Buddha through.
Connected, man.
Let's do it.
Whoa. We connected. Buddha, what's
Whoa.
Up, man?
Whoa.
Karma 3, what is this, midnight? Wake up. I done a lot. Nappy dread with me. Yelling bumper clock. I just bought another Glock. Get your ass a stomach shot. Slap him. Duct tape him. Kidnap him. Cop a rollie on him. Bust it down and wear your wrist at him. The way I turned 21, I went savage. Dope fiends, I'm cool with they.
Students to see how kids are adapting to wearing masks while learning and playing.
It keeps you from not breathing.
I think it feels sweaty on.
You uncomfortable with the mask.
You feel uncomfortable with the mask? Maybe we'll have to keep the mask on. Some of the children struggled with the mask. They were hot, they were sweaty, they couldn't breathe. They made complaints, but they did reinforce that they understood it was important for them to wear it because of safety.
The kids' cameras also captured the five students, ages 4 and 5, at times during the 60 minutes, adjusting the masks, fixing them when they were falling off their faces, and even sneezing into them.
Coronavirus.
The average person out there, the average citizen, that mask is not going to protect them. And as a matter of fact, in most cases, they're actually going to increase their risk of being contaminated with a virus when they're wearing that mask improperly, because they tend to touch their face. They tend to move it around. It's very uncomfortable. It's hard to breathe in. Not only are you not preventing yourself from getting a disease, you may be increasing your chance of getting a disease by wearing that mask.
Yeah, and the reason I made this video is just to demonstrate that even though we know that them damn face masks ain't doing nothing to protect nobody from a virus, from a tiny virus which can pass through the pores in that thing, we know that. But even by the logic of the people who push the mask of the beast, that you're not supposed to fiddle with a mask to protect yourself and to be safe, right? Let me tell you something, it's damn near impossible to work an 8-hour shift, to go on a medium to long term journey, to do an entire supermarket trip without fiddling, without adjusting the mask, without taking it off to eat, without using the restroom and washing your hands, and without getting it wet through rain and coughing into it. If you cough into your mask and you continue to wear it, you're nasty as all hell, you understand? So even according to their own logic, them face masks are not protecting nobody from nothing, you understand? And it doesn't matter if you don't fiddle in a mask, because the virus will pass through that thing anyway. And on top of that, it's completely unnecessary to mask and muzzle the entire population for a mild flu-like virus, the likes of which we see every flu season. You understand? It's completely and utterly overboard and an exaggeration to put a mask on children, to put a mask on young children who aren't affected by this thing, healthy adults, you understand? People who are asymptomatic, you understand? To put a mandate, a mask for everybody, that it's a complete overreaction. So even if the mask was to work, it is completely unnecessary for a virus of this low magnitude. RIP everyone who died of the flu, but you don't shut down the world for that.